Hey, Ospin and Snakeo here with another figure review. This time I've got the Playarts Kai Uncharted 3 Drake's Deception Nathan Drake figure. I'm a huge fan of the game series. I've played all three of them a couple of times through. Really love the story, really love the action, really love everything about those games. They've just got better as the series gone. I really hope there is a fourth, but probably be on the PS4. So we shall wait and see. But onto this guy. Like I said, big fan of the series, and when I saw that they did a figure in this new Playarts Kai series of figures, which I've just started collecting, I was like, yeah, definitely have to be. He's one of my favourite characters in games. I just love his cheekiness, his sass, his survivability. So yeah, very, very happy that I managed to pick this guy up. I got him off eBay from the eBuyer SBoy13UK. I paid £51 for the figure, £10 for postage, so that's quite, it's a bit more than I'd like to pay, but you know, these things are so rare, and this guy, I've seen him going for like £200, so very, very happy that I was able to get him at a reasonable price. I've got the box with him as well, so just bear me 2 seconds, and we'll go on to the figure in a minute. Let's go over the box, let's put him over there, bring in this tower of a box. This is lovely box. Got some nice, wash in the background. Picture the figure, Drake's free, Uncharted 3, Drake's Deception, Nathan Drake, Playarts, action figures, Kai. And then you've got the Naughty Dog logo, who's the company that actually make the games. Nice box on the front, nice picture on the front even. Got Uncharted again on the side. On the top of the box, that's upside down. Other side, same as the other side. Just a little bit of a warning label on the bottom. On the back, you've got some snapshots of him. It's actually a figure doing his poses, so I've seen him do that pose in the actual like game, so that's why they did that. So loads of Japanese writing. Collection Action Fury Scissors in the series. And he's actually got a window view, or a door view rather. And you've got where's his weapons, where you've got the pistol, the AK-47, sorry, and then the Dragon Sniper Rifle. So that's pretty cool they did that, because it's supposed to be like his little journal that he has with him. And he's also got this massive bio, which I'm not going to read. I'll try and get in focus so you guys can read it. See how well that does. That's pretty good. I'll leave it there for a sec. And there's the last 2-3 bits of the bomb. Nice little pictures. It's very, very nice box. It's one of my favourite boxes, actually. It's really, really nice. Put that to one side. And then we get on to this guy. This guy's got a really great skull to him. There's great textures all throughout. Gripes, I have, let's see, one, two. Yeah, just two, really. I can't really think of anything else, which I'll go over in a sec. Let's go over his accessories first. He comes with 4 hands in total, so the gun hands, and then 2 fist hands. If I just get that in focus, bring the lid a bit closer. Focus. There we go. It's got some nice texture, like supposed to be like a bit hairy. A bit like the Chris Redfield's face. These ones are got that texture of hair. He's also got the same texture on his arms and on his chin, luckily not all over his face. They're both the same, just flying around the place, just left and right fist, so nice sculpt, nice detail. And then he's got the two other ones. He comes with 3 weapons. He's got, like I said, the Dragon Sniper Rifle, which is actually really, really nicely sculpted. Only 2 colours in it, I believe. Yep, just got this like dark kind of matte green, and then like this like lighty darky grey. Seems to be all one piece, bar the scope seems to be separate, so it's pretty cool. Some nice details, a little bit of the bolt there. Nice like fire, like almost, I don't know what kind of texture it is. It's supposed to give like a grip on there and there, but I don't know, it's kind of weird, it's like bobbly, but it's still cool to put it in, so that's cool. He's then got his AK-47, which is very, very cool. Big fan of this gun. He's actually got a retractable stock. No, that's not right. Shoulder guard. I'm losing my words today. Anyway, moving on. Some great details on the actual sculpt. some nice paint apps on the actual wooden parts. It's generally the solid colour with a little bit of a metallic kind of airbrush. It's very little, and then like the woodens are the separate two pieces, like the gun and then the shoulder guard. And like I said, it collapses and it holds itself quite nicely, so that's pretty cool. So don't have to really worry about that just swinging out. And then finally he's got his pistol, which goes into his little holster very nicely. It does actually look quite reminiscent of the game. It's been a couple of months since I've played the games. Actually, I haven't played any this year, so quite a few months. So I vaguely remember the pistol looking a bit like this. It's been a while. Solid colour. It's like solid grey. Yeah, there's no like paint details in it. I know it looks like there's some there, but I think that's just a bit of a wear and tear. Yeah, so that's scratching right off. But nice detail on it. It's a good little gun. It kind of looks a bit like the Colt 45, but not quite. But anyway, there you go. So that's his accessories. Onto this guy. So let's straighten him out, and then I'll show you some of his decals. I actually got this figure broken, but it did say that on the description. Basically, what happened is this ball here just wouldn't stay in the arm, and I don't really use them twists whatsoever, so a bit of glue, done, fixed. And now I can pick it up by it, so that was it. tell a lie, this had come out of the factory and this would not turn, so I heated up, popped it out, then put it back on, and now it turns absolutely fine. So that was the only real problems I had with the figure, as in faults. I've got, like I said, a few grubs about the actual design of the figure, but you know, they've learned, because this is quite an old figure, it came out quite a while back. But anyway, onto this character. He's got a really nice face sculpt. I wouldn't say it's spot on to Nathan Drake, but I do think it's pretty reminiscent. And if you look at the whole figure, you see Nathan Drake. He's got a great kind of quiff of hair that he has. Like a bit of a broody kind of look. Very dark 5 o'clock shadow, which is all textured. The hair is actually a soft rubber, so it's a separate piece. So, I don't know, I think it's pretty cool. Bit blurry. It's okay. It's like I said, it's not a spot on from Nathan Drake, but I do think it's pretty cool. Now, the scarf, I noticed, is actually a separate piece, but it's not removable. I don't know if I'd make it removable, because it's like a softer rubber, or if I'll just leave it. I'm not a big fan of like the scarf look, but I do like, I don't want to leave like chunks in it or anything. So, this is also a separate piece, so that moves freely. It's glued like up here, but it doesn't hinder the articulation whatsoever. It moves very freely. And the crutch piece here is a separate piece as well, so that moves freely. So, and is also a softer rubber, so it won't hinder the movement when you try and, well, flex him. So, yeah, I mean, he's got some great textures in his shirt. His shirt's like overlapping his belt on this side, which he kind of constantly has. He's got a very scruffy look, which the leather center leg. He's got this really cool little watch, which is really, really nicely detailed. I'm seeing him with that. And what's pretty cool is, if I bend his arm, is he's got this like trademark, like I think they're called jersey shirts, I don't know, long sleeve shirt. And when you pull it up, it actually has sculpted sleeve on there, so it hides it really, really well. I'm sure I remember seeing a review for this guy, and that was just painted, so I don't know if this is like an upgrade in the figure or what, I'm not too sure. But really nice details in the wrinkles, in the cloth, the trousers, the pockets, the boots have got some great detail as well, nice treads as well. Get the ammunition belt, really, really nice, plus his ammo pockets there. More pockets on the back, plus his little classic holster thing. And then the holster. That's actually quite a solid plastic. I was expecting that to be quite soft, but I mean, this bit bends, but no bend in it. No real ply movement in it, but doesn't hinder the articulation in any way. Speaking of, let's go over his articulation. The head is on a double ball peg, yeah, but it's quite hindered by the hair and the scarf, so you can't really go back all that much unless it starts pulling it apart there, so that's not great. So that's about as high as you can go, which isn't all that really. Down quite nicely, and then 360 around, yeah, not really hindered at all. It's a bit over the scarf, but it's fine. The shoulders have the butterfly joints, which are quite traditional for Playhouse Kai, and then they are on ball discs, so they can go up to there and then all the way around, obviously. biceps on a 360. And then you've got the double-sided peg, so you probably could spin there and there. I'm not going to try it because the sculpt doesn't really allow it. Then he's got a single cut on the ball, which is past 90 degrees, which is very nice. And then the wrist is also on a double ball, so you can spin it round and go down to there, up to there, rotate full 360 at there, rotate full 360 at there. So you can get plenty of range, pretty much any which way you want. And they've got a nice soft ratchet, so they're holding, but they're not like really like kind of ratchets. He's got double diaphragm joint, which is classic for Playhouse Kai. Just one sec, something's under my elbow. It's not very comfortable. So you can do, I don't think you can go full 360, no. And not much forward on the upper joint. Not much back either, so you've just basically got a 90 degree turn to there, arm straight, so to there, a bit more right than he has got left. Then you've got another joint here, which is very flexible, so all the way back. Oops, move the camera to that one, and quite far forward. Not massive, to be honest, I'd like a bit more, since he's quite a monkey when it comes to climbing and all that. But then you've also got a twist there, which is only hindered by this bit of cloth. Then you've got T-cut hips, so yay! He's got a Spartan kick of there. So it's not terrible, but it's not massive either. And he's got a split kick of that, so that's pretty cool. And that's actually one of my gripes, is the hips. They are like the Batman figure, the older style ones. They are very smooth, so very loose. Quite loose in the legs. So I'll take them off, put a bit of glue on there, and then tie them up, and hopefully not have a repeat of the Dark Knight figure. Anyway, moving on. The double knee joint, so two pegs there. This is another one of my gripes. It's not a massive bend. Normally they always go pretty much full. It's quite a big joint, but it's not terrible. It's quite well hidden. And then what I was surprised at is he's actually got some ankle pivot. Chris Redfield had like nothing because of the trousers, they just blocked him, but now he can go from there to there, and then it's at that angle where the peg's kind of going like that, so you can rock it and get a bit of a slant. Not massive, the trousers do hinder that, but there is something there, which is very nice. So that's pretty cool. So let's just stand him up. Moving back, he is on the short side. They seem to be growing their Playhouse Kais as they're going along. So if I bring my shortest Playhouse Kai I've got to date, Batman, he's shorter than Batman. So it's not really going well with my consistency of my characters from video games. Stand, Batman. There you go. If I grab the tallest character I've got, which is the Virgil transformed into custom Resident Evil 5 Albert Wesker, Skadoosh. I mean, this guy is a giant. I don't know why he is so big. I'm thinking of maybe customizing, taking out a bit of his waist and bring him down. And maybe his legs as well. I mean, look at that. His belt is at his breast plate. Or chest, whatever you want to call it. That's stupid. That's just, ugh. Whatever. Bringing in Sheva. And finally, we'll bring in Chris. Oh, I'll keep the Resident Evil pie going. So, as you can see, stand Chris, there you go. As you can see, he's quite a small figure in comparison to other players' guys, so, I don't know, it's a bit of a bummer. I don't know how tall he's supposed to be in game. I know he's not like a giant, but still, it's kind of a bit of a bummer that they can't keep their figures a consistent height, because this is quite a nice height. I like that height. I can deal with this height, but that guy's just too tall. Not happy about that. But anyway, there you go, guys. That is my Playhouse Kai Uncharted 3 Nathan Drake figure. If you can find him cheap, then I would definitely recommend picking him up. He's a great figure to have to your Playhouse Kai collection. It comes with all his like traditional weapons. And now I'm going to go play the game. So thanks a lot for watching, guys. I hope you liked it. As usual, leave comments and links below. And I will catch you later. Bye-bye.